However you like it, just like it, just every way chance to on podcast. Your boys are back in the building. We welcome you back. The first show on TCP of the new year.
Why are you looking at me like that? Struggling. It's all ahead, but not finished.
You're mad.
Oh, my goodness. Don't cut me off in the middle of it.
I didn't. You looked at me and said, what are you looking at?
Stop. Listen, like I said, first show of the new year. We're back in the building. To my right, we have everybody's favorite Puerto Rican, Mr. Jacqueline Ruiz. Ooh. Hashtag nine toes down. Ooh. It might be another one by the time we have another show.
Ooh. Jesus Christ, man. Five.
Wow.
Well, how many times we remind us? It's five now.
It's not been nine. Five for a long
nine
time,
is so bad.
Thank you for down. Another one?
Oh. Yo, you're a real. But it's okay.
I know what you are.
I think that deserves an apology. I apologize.
That everybody's favorite.
That one deserves an apology.
That's
a lot of bad things in your life.
No, but that one was wrong. That was wrong.
What?
I apologize.
I missed it.
Good. How was your holiday, man?
No, I'm not going to go on to you. What did I miss? No, I'm going to start off the new year on a bad note. What did I miss?
It's not a bad note.
What did you told me to forget it?
Red.
Yes, sir.
How was your holidays, man?
My holidays were fantastic.
What'd you do?
And a little get together with the family, just, you know, small.
Don't try to cover it up.
Four or five adults and a few children.
Don't try to cover it up.
My kids, you know, my kids had a great time, obviously. You know what? I was saying this to my, who was I saying this? I think somebody asked me if your kids had a good Christmas. They always ask that. And I said, well, yeah, because they got everything they wanted. They got, what? Make sure it's on. I felt like you should have did this. I don't know. Is it on now?
It's on now.
It's on. My mic off.
Yeah.
Oh, rookie. Sorry, man. Our producer sometimes, you know, he comes in and he's a little shaky. He sometimes is a little shaky.
He's looking for a mic now.
Sometimes our producer gets on, he's a little shaky. That's all I'm saying.
Oh,
nothing personal. Anyway, let me get back to what I was saying first. Hold on. It's not personal. Anyway, so I was saying to this person, they asked me if your kids had a good Christmas. I said they always have a good Christmas because they always get what they want. So, you know, they open up everything. They got everything they want, so there's no complaints. It's not like, oh, they didn't get what they want. I want to know one year when they don't get what they want, if they had a good Christmas or not.
You'll be the last one.
So I don't want to, like, one year I'm not going to give them something that they want, whatever it is. I'm just going to be like, how do you feel about that? I want to see his face. I think I'm going to do it.
So you're just not going to give the kid what they want for Christmas?
Yeah. I never got what I wanted when I was a kid for Christmas. Not once.
But they didn't do it on purpose, man.
Yeah.
You know what? I agree with you.
It's different.
But I want to do it on purpose.
But the level of a-hole that you are.
It's a top level.
Oh, top tier. I taught you well.
Yo, you are like alarming you.
I know.
I probably act like you when I don't turn your mic on.
My mic's on. Is it on now? Is it on?
No, you just jabbing your back. You know,
he set the mics up.
Listen.
Yeah, I'm like, I don't get blamed for everything.
It's a team atmosphere.
It's not just
a team atmosphere. We're not throwing nobody under the bus.
Wow.
You do that very well.
You're
the best bus thrower I've ever seen.
Listen, man, moving forward. Yesterday, last big games.
Well, my holidays were great, thanks. New Year's was good too.
I thought you were done.
Yeah, well, you didn't ask me.
He kind of did.
No, he didn't ask me if I was done.
You went into a whole denying your kids Christmas. Spiel.
Yeah,
let's get back on topic here, man.
All right.
We're back. Yesterday, we saw a big college playoff. Which one you guys want to start with first?
The obvious one.
Notre Dame.
Well, see, it's not obvious because I don't think you're saying
another year passes, and like it's either the Cowboys, Notre Dame.
Where the Cowboys come from?
Because it's teams that I hate. That I always enjoy seeing them not succeed. It's like it warms my heart for like Notre Dame to always tell you how good they are. It's a different year. It's a different team, same results. And it is what it is. They joined the ACC this year because out of necessity, and they got what they wanted.
Won 10 games. Good season.
Right. But you lost. You got blown out by Clemson. You beat Clemson when they were down their best players, and you beat them. That's cool. But what did you really expect? It was a little bit more competitive than I thought it was going to be. But
was it?
I was expecting like 50.
It was a blowout.
But they held them in, as opposed to what they've been doing all year, they held them in quote-unquote check. So Devontae Smith looked great. I think he should win the Heisman.
Yo, that too is fun. I don't know how I feel about Alabama receivers in the NFL. Julio Jones, a great one. Ridley's okay.
Amari Cooper.
For what they were in college, because we're seeing Jerry Jeudy is.
He's a rookie year. Quarterback, depending on like that.
Ruggs knows his rookie year, but Ruggs looks terrible.
Not terrible. That's the society we live in. You gotta stop doing that.
Ruggs look terrible.
Terrible?
Yeah, terrible.
Is they're not an all star?
No, you don't have to be an all star. You just have to somewhat exist.
Okay.
And I don't feel like he did.
So, Devontae.
Oh, boy.
He gets the top speed.
But you know what, though? If Waddle was still around, he would have been the best player on that team. He'd be the best receiver on that team.
No.
You didn't hear Smith until Waddle got hurt. Then Smith all over the place.
20 touchdowns later.
Waddle was killing it, though. Waddle's first three games, he was murdering the people.
It's safe to say you would have heard about Devontae. Instead of 20,
Waddle would have been the best receiver on the team, though.
You've been hearing about Devontae.
Waddle was the best player when he got hurt.
Devontae Smith may be the best player in college football.
He should win the
Heisman. If Waddle was still on the team, he wouldn't be.
He wouldn't win the Heisman, probably, yes.
Oh, he definitely wouldn't.
But
neither one of them would be up for Heisman because they would have had to share the load a lot.
Exactly.
But Waddle would have been the best receiver on that team.
Stop talking. That's blasphemy.
It's not blasphemy. See, that's the same. Y'all got just short memories. It's such a problem.
We're all getting older. It might not be a short memory. You can't recall.
Anyway, did Notre Dame do what you guys expect them to do?
Yeah, they lost by a lot.
Nobody thought
they would compete.
All you guys thought they were going to get blown out? Nobody thought they had a shot?
They didn't have a shot. They shouldn't have been in the playoffs. They didn't have a chance because they shouldn't have been there. They got blown out by Clemson when Clemson finally had their starting quarterback.
And they won every other
they
game.
They still could jump. They go from 2-4. We all know it's a money grab because Notre Dame is a popular school and they're a big school. And it's a money grab. Kind of leaders of Rice keep voting them in every single year. They keep getting blown out
Did I call him the Donald Trump podcast already?
Kind of leaders of Rice is a Republican. What do you care?
But you kind of miss it. It's not just her. It's everybody.
No, but you go to the one black woman that's on the football committee.
Because she shouldn't be on the committee.
None of them should be on it. They keep voting in the wrong team.
The committee's a bad committee. That's why I said they should get a different committee every year. You have the same committee, and what happens? Okay, for a few different people that had left and some others came in, predominantly, the committee is the same. And they vote the same teams. Granted, Clemson, Alabama deserve it every year. No question. Ohio State's kind of working their way into that, where they kind of deserve it every year if they're undefeated, yes. But Notre Dame not one of those teams. And then they get in, and they get blown out, and then they have their coach, Kelly, go on stage and say, well, we're still going to get here every year, regardless of what happens.
I wouldn't say that about
you're an a-hole.
About Ohio
State. Kelly made me mad with that comment.
I wouldn't say that about Ohio State. I feel like the Big Ten needs to, top to bottom, it's probably the weakest conference in the Power Five. So
right now. No,
They've been.
They're better than Pac-12.
And you don't see a Pac-12 team hardly ever in the playoffs.
Ohio State is in the national championship game.
Okay, this is an anomaly. I'm just saying every year it shouldn't be an automatic Ohio State should be in there. Grant, this year they showed they deserved. And I'm not arguing this year. I'm just saying they're not Alabama Clemson yet. They have to start playing better teams out of conference because the Big Ten is weak, top to bottom.
I'm by no means a Ohio State fan. I'm probably close to an Ohio State hater. You can't keep an undefeated out. And they're undefeated every year. This year, they only want
Cincinnati. I would love to see Cincinnati in there just for the sake of it.
Love to see Cincinnati. Well, my whole point.
Here we go with the
Notre Dame. No, because there's also another team that probably deserved to be in.
No, there was
Texas A&M.
Yeah.
No,
the only team they lost to was Alabama. So if a team can lose to in their conference finals, like Notre Dame did, even though they don't even play in the conference ever until this year, they lost to a team that looked super, so much better, 100 times better.
Texas A&M was not, they didn't lose to them in the conference championship.
I'm not talking about Texas A&M, I'm talking about Notre Dame losing to Clemson.
Hey, we got a comment. We got a comment from Jordan Tony. He says, why would he say I don't want to play in the championship?
Who said that?
No, he's talking about Coach Kelly.
Gotcha.
Yeah, he wouldn't say that. That's why he said we're going to get back every year, regardless of the scores and whatever. I don't think Notre Dame's a bad team. They're a good team.
So what's your beef?
But they're not an elite team like the Clemson's and Alabama's.
Clemson didn't look too good either.
When I talked to you on the phone yesterday, you said, yeah, Cincinnati would have gave them a game.
Cincinnati would have gave Notre Dame
a game. They were undefeated. And I'm not saying they even deserve to be in, but they deserve some consideration. But being ranked number 9 in the country, you don't even get consideration. You got to be in that top 5 or 6 to get consideration.
It's hard, man.
They weren't considered.
You can't
compete. They're an undefeated team.
You can't compete when you're beating Toledo. You know,
the mid-majors don't stand a chance, ever.
They don't need to.
What do you mean? Cincinnati hung with Georgia all day yesterday, the day before yesterday. And they should have won. Their coach, you know what? The reason, I told you this on the phone. Cincinnati's coaches lost in that game. Maybe they don't deserve to be in the championship, but the players deserve at least consideration.
You want to throw the coaches under the bus?
The coaches ruined that game for them.
Sometimes, yeah.
It was 1:41 to go, and what they do? They passed the ball on 3rd-and-2. Georgia had no timeouts. They could have ran the clock down to under a minute, correct?
Correct.
We're both coaches. We're all 3 coaches at one point, right?
Yeah.
They could have ran the ball. They could have ran the clock down, even if they ran it, they didn't get the first down. 2 yards, I'm thinking they're going to get the first down. But if not, what happens? They run the clock down under a minute. They punt the ball away. Georgia has to go, let's say, 70 yards at minimum from where they were at in the field in under a minute, or say 50 seconds. No timeouts.
Mm-hmm.
They kick that field goal with 9 seconds to go. That game would have been over.
You think?
They had 1:41. That's why they had more time.
Right now, you're saying Cincinnati deserved to be there because they played Georgia in a good game.
It's triangle theory, man. That's all you have to do.
No, that's not what I'm saying. I'm saying they deserve consideration. They weren't even considered.
No, they're
because they're not a mid. Any other Power 5 team that's 9-0, 10-0 gets consideration. Why doesn't Cincinnati?
They probably considered them.
Coastal Carolina was 12-0.
Listen, somebody in that meeting probably said, hey, what about Cincinnati?
They're not going to bring in as much money as Notre Dame.
That's exactly my point.
That's the problem.
They don't create the dollar sign that Notre Dame does. They got their own channel.
This was the year they could have did it. Every other year, because these teams and their fans travel very well. But that wasn't an option this year.
Exactly.
They didn't have... They could have made a point this year to
let us
Cincinnati.
Me and him, I don't know where you at, but me and him are here.
They could have let us Cincinnati in just to prove the point that
I'm waiting my turn patiently.
They're the better team, and let them show it on the field. And if they get blown out, then hey, we were wrong. But that's the whole point of a tournament style, a playoff. Like what makes it on paper? You say Notre Dame is better than Cincinnati. That's all you got is on paper.
You know, no, they play you guys on the field, said that they deserve consideration.
They did.
Correct. Okay, so. One person in that meeting probably said, hey, what about Cincinnati? Another person probably said, yeah, right.
But why are they saying, yeah, right? Is it because of the team on the field or because of the history?
Because when you beat Akron, Toledo, Miami of Ohio, nobody cares that you're undefeated. That's just the way it works in college football.
Okay.
Moving forward.
Yeah, let's talk about another heartwarming moment yesterday watching Dabo Sweeney have the... That crow, because he talked a lot.
I hate Dabo.
Hey, yeah,
he started hating Dabo because of his political beliefs, though. That's not fair.
Could you imagine Trevor Lawrence, one of the greatest college quarterbacks of all time, and I don't think that's putting it lightly. He won the national championship as a freshman, if I'm not mistaken, and he had to celebrate it by eating Big Macs and cold French fries. You know what I mean? Like that happened. And I feel that if Clemson would have found a way to win the national title, I feel Clemson would have found a way to get to the White House before January 20th. That's how big of a MAGA supporter Dabo is. And that's why, not just that, because we're all entitled to our own political beliefs. And like, so I'm not really, it's everything else where Dabo feels that he's given this platform as one of the top, he's one of the top two or three coaches in college football, obviously. But when he told us that we should have just been happy with Obama as president, that should have been enough. You start seeing red flags coming up. When he's telling people they should leave the country if they don't agree with what he thinks is right, another red flag. And it's like, Dabo, he's not really likable, so I don't see how these, like, I just don't see what is there to support with Dabo moving forward. I feel like he's hurting his brand a whole lot more, unless he's going to get that Alabama job when Nick Saban leaves.
No, he's like getting
that. Why wouldn't he? He's younger.
He went to Alabama.
He's an Alabama alum. I think that's his dream job.
He would fit in, but I don't think he's getting it. I don't think Dabo's story is going to end well soon.
Oh, something's going to come up.
Like, well, yeah, because his there's only so long black players are going to keep supporting Clemson.
Well, as long as there is a straight path to the NFL.
As long as you're winning, man, I think black players are going to show up regardless.
No, that's not the case.
You say that.
He's an obvious...
Nick Saban is an unlikable person to want to play for.
It's not really unlikable.
He's not a player's coach, is my mean.
I think he is. I think players at that young age, they gravitate towards him.
Saban,
Dabo. Like, politically,
you make that kid from NFL cry when he goes for the Dolphins.
Offensive
lineman.
Saban
do left practice crying, a grown man.
Saban's relatable. Like, you see Saban at the players' houses doing the electric slides, whatever, and everything else.
But in
Dabo, he's talking about Black Lives Don't Matter, basically.
Did he say that? The point. I think don't Dabo.
He didn't say those words.
But I think I completely understand. He's bitching about them and going to vote. Yes. Like, I understand that. I think he's good old country boy that doesn't realize that he sounds out of touch.
One of his coaches said the N-word, and nothing happened to him.
Really?
I didn't hear that.
So.
Yeah.
But what's it? Was it? There's no reason for it. No, he didn't get a pass for saying it.
It's like, I hate.
He didn't explain why he said it. Right?
Yes.
But almost, I'm only saying this, I want to be fair to people. I don't want to just say those things.
You have to be fair to racists.
That's what some 45 does that sometimes. We shouldn't be that way.
We're not. Did the coach not call the kid an N-word?
No. He didn't call. He repeated
the N-word.
He repeated the same sentence that kid said.
Why does he have the right to repeat that?
I'm not saying he doesn't. I'm saying.
No, that's the people that take
privilege. I'm saying that word in. I understand what he was doing at the time. I think he did it in bad taste, but I understand what he was doing. He was trying to use it as a teachable moment. But that's a sensitive word. You can't just yell that up.
No, that's not a teachable moment. You're trying to embarrass the kid.
I'm just telling you what he said.
Listen.
What Dabo said.
I understand.
You try to use it as a teachable moment. He said, my bad, I was to block that N-word. That's what he said. And he said,
that makes it sound worse.
It does. But that's what the kid said. This black, black player said this. Yeah. And that coach just repeated exactly what he said.
Right.
And that was it. I'm just saying. I know it's not a politically right thing to say.
Sound like you're defending him.
I'm not defending him. If you would just listen sometimes.
I'm listening.
You're not.
Listening.
You just hear what you want.
Is he defending him?
Am I defending him? He don't know.
Because he
doesn't know yet.
He don't want to speak his mind.
Why would he not? I just talked to the kid. He look.
He might be scared of you. Never know.
Why the hell would he be scared of me? I ain't never threatened the kid or nothing.
Yeah.
He's a grown ass man. He ain't scared of nobody.
Listen. Bottom line is, you're defending your boy.
You're unbelievable.
Dabo's your boy. We get it.
I never liked Dabo. Not once. And this is before you found out he was a MAGA guy and started hating him. I didn't like him before then.
No, I didn't like him for a while, man. I wasn't because of MAGA. MAGA's one of them. Listen, let's talk about the game.
Yeah, let's talk about the game.
I mean, to stay on topic and to kind of like bring in another topic together, like with what Booger McFarland said about black players having more worried about their TikToks and their Instagram than realizing that pro football game and college has become a business. Year round, and guys like you, as a former college athlete, guys like Dabo are the guys you have to impress. You have to, you know, by all means, you have to get on the coach's good side. Like, it kind of takes away, it could take away from who you are as a person, but as long as you reach the field, you kind of, you know, there's an ends to a mean. And meet or means to end, however it is.
Yeah, you're right.
So, what do you guys agree with what McFarland said, that it's most 70% NFL? I don't know, you know, college is a whole lot bigger number, but do you agree with what he said or disagree? Do you feel like it was in bad taste? Like, continuing with the Dabo, because I feel like these players, this is their one shot. They're trying to make it out. Most of them, broken families, you know, maybe no father figure. Dabo comes in, offers you a full ride scholarship to a top program in the country.
Come play for Massa.
That's the way you want to look at it. But
you can pay a lot of money. Like J.J. Watt said, we're getting paid a lot of money to play a game. If you can't keep your focus and stay out of strip clubs for 16 weeks, then you got a problem.
Do you feel that Dwayne becomes a problem with Dwayne Haskins because he's not performing on the field? But if you perform, it goes under the rug. He's not good enough to have the extra baggage. Is that what it is?
He's not, number one. But not only that, he's really young. He's not Peyton Manning. Peyton Manning and them guys, even Lamar Jackson, he can get away with it.
But I feel like
those guys prove that they can play in this league.
But I feel literally any
this
other
guy year. This guy has done nothing. You are a backup quarterback and you're going to the strip club during a pandemic?
But literally any other year, it's the worst division in the history of football. A 4 or 5 win team isn't eligible to win it. Whatever it ends up being, 6 wins.
It's going to be 7.
Any other year, he would have just been able to have been a backup, learning. Like, you can tell Ron Rivera don't like the kid. And he's probably not likable. But I feel like it's a whole cluster of the situation that makes guys like Dwayne Haskins or Juju or whomever that tries to, you know, it's not an issue with Tom Brady when he promotes himself.
Juju been dancing the whole season. It only became a problem when they started losing.
Or when his numbers don't add up.
Well, the numbers didn't matter. Nobody knows this guy dancing until they lost their second game in a row. When they lost their second game in a row, then it was a big deal. Juju's out there dancing on the logo.
I didn't want to make it such like an NFL thing because we're still in college. Like, it's just more.
It could be an NFL thing.
No, but more so what McFarland said and pretty much any black analyst on ESPN.
Do you agree with what Berger said, though? I don't. Hold on.
Put context to what he said. He said they care more about their followers than actually producing on the field or whatever, right?
Right.
So, to put that in context, nowadays, like, teams are where people or players are worried about their brand. They're worried about what they can make off the field. I think Booger has more insight and just couldn't elaborate more on what he wanted to say without throwing people up under the bus.
I think Booger was frustrated. Yeah. That came from a person that wholeheartedly cares.
He was frustrated in the game. He was frustrated
with seeing that from African-American players. I don't think he should have let it come out where it came out.
What bothers me the most about it is when, and this topic comes up with Dwayne Haskins, we always refer to Jamarcus Russell. We don't bring up Johnny Manziel. We don't bring up Ryan Leaf. We don't bring up a whole host of other white quarterbacks that did way worse.
Jamarcus was maybe the biggest bust of all time.
No.
Ryan Leaf.
It's not Ryan. I can't think of his name right now, but there's a guy that the Baltimore Colts drafted in the 80s, and he got arrested for gambling, and he got banned from the league.
But Jamarcus was number one pick.
Right.
He just didn't want it. 12 sleeping meetings.
The league will do that to you.
He came to camp 300 pounds.
It should have made him a guard.
Like, the guy. Ryan Leaf didn't pan out in the NFL. He was a terrible quarterback in the NFL. But he didn't come in camp at 300 pounds. It was like, Jamarcus didn't care.
He's trying to fight.
I think Ryan's a terrible fucking quarterback.
Comments.
Ron was a terrible quarterback.
We got a comment from Clovis Gavin.
Clovis.
Dixon Reader.
He says.
Yeah, he don't like your reading skills.
You made it seem like
you dropped out or something. Hold on.
It's definitely all subjective.
You might be able to get away with.
I could have read that.
I'm not perfect. I felt like you're perfect with him.
He cut me off on that one.
He was going to read it.
I'm gonna read the next comment.
Okay.
That's messed up.
Like, I was gonna be there, like,
he's been jabbing you all show.
I didn't catch the first joke.
Listen.
I'm gonna talk about that, okay?
He made you four extra toes. Nobody's jabbing nothing.
You should be mad about that. He gave you all them extra toes for no reason.
In response to Clovis Gallon's comment, that's true. Because nobody partied harder than Allen Iverson. And
I don't want to say that. Well, Michael Irvin was. Never mind. Never mind. No, I know he's a cowboy. I want to smoke.
His college life. Like, a lot of times it starts in college life.
Hey, we once interviewed a guy.
The more.
Not a tough story. We once interviewed a guy that played at the U with Mike Irvin down there. And man, oh man, he has some stories for us. And that might have been the greatest interview we. It only lasted me, what, 15 minutes?
Yeah, probably.
Might have been the greatest interview we ever gave.
We gotta get him back on the show.
Like, we gotta have him. That's like, yo, he was telling us stuff that was like, until I heard it when he walked away, I'm like, I love that guy.
Can't viewers go to Roku TV and look up that episode, look up that interview? Is it on there?
It is on. You know what? We do have it on Wax.
You can go to Roku TV and check it out.
Roku TV. You can get it up there. It was the Lancaster Lebanon Media Day. We were there. That's what it was. And it's on there. We also had the Selango coach ducking and dodging bullets.
Chill, sorry, man.
Nah, you always try to let stuff slide, man.
We ain't doing that here.
I said, why come over here then if you ain't going to answer no questions? Like, why come to our table?
You didn't have the energy there.
I didn't have the energy? I'm the only one to ask the question.
Yeah, they gave you an answer and you let it,
that was BS.
All right.
Still mad about it. Y'all let him the hook.
You let them off the hook. You asked the question.
We know who they are. And you let them off the hook.
Chill. I love for my people in Selango, man.
I ain't got no love for them over there.
He's a good dude.
And then on top of that, now I'm getting this off my chest. And on top of that, they pulled me over to some little black kid that was like a sophomore running back that was never going to play.
We don't know that.
Stop. He was never going to play.
They brought
him over to say, hey, got this black kid with us. We do got black kids over here. I'm offended right away. When he was walking over, I told him, only seniors come over, seniors and captains. This kid, they had to literally go down to the freshman team to find. There's not even a starter.
So
and they brought him over to the table to interview with us. And this guy said, he's not even a football player, he said, I'm a wrestler. I couldn't believe it. And they didn't attack this guy. But I'm the wrong one.
Dabo would have been proud.
No, we're not. It wasn't the platform for that, man.
It was the platform. It ain't the platform now? Yeah. Is that not what they supposed to do here? It's not what we do here.
Listen, man. Moving forward. Who you taking first?
You let him off the hook again.
What you talking about?
Go ahead. You want to talk about something else? Fine.
Man.
Justin,
all right.
Listen, I said.
But now I'm just a Republican, right?
You're the Donald Trump.
Right, that's right. But I mean, it is what it is.
I said the AD's a good guy, so I know that. I can vouch for him.
He's a do-nothing Democrat.
Listen, do-nothing Democrat over there.
I can vouch for the AD at Selanka. Everybody else?
AD was, you know what? He's the only AD that came with his team. He's the only one that came to our table.
Ooh, why did he?
The only AD that came to our table. You know what? He answered all the questions.
He did.
He wouldn't let his head coach answer no question until he walked away quick.
Ooh, that's a red flag.
I'm telling you, man, it was so fishy. I don't care because I don't ever care to get any of them back on this show. I just know it was a problem. Go ahead. You gotta move forward.
Move forward. You have the number one pick in the draft, or are you still stuck on Trevor Lawrence? Do you feel like he's a generational talent? Was he exposed last night?
No.
No, okay. I'm asking the question. I feel like
he also turned that thing over.
I feel like social media turned on the kid. Like, you forget that was the only second game that he lost in his career.
34-2.
So, but in the NFL game, I like what I see with Justin Fields, and that's not really any slight towards Trevor Lawrence. But if I'm Jacksonville, I might look in the Justin Fields direction over Trevor Lawrence.
Wow!
I really don't think.
Did you see Justin Fields' last three games before that?
I saw him when it mattered. I saw him when he took that hit. I thought he had some broken.
What about last year when it mattered?
He played good in the game. Him and his receiver had some cross wires, and he thought he went left. Zig when he hit his leg, then he ended up.
You can't judge it off one.
Oh, no, I'm not judging it off one game.
I like Justin Fields, too. He should have been a Penn State.
I feel like he's a top. Was that ever really an option?
He was committed to Penn State.
Oh, I didn't know that.
that he decommitted and went to Georgia.
He just got a big recruit over the weekend, Makai Flowers.
Makai Flowers, shout out to Steel High Coach Irby. That's a big recruit for them guys. Shout out to Coach Irby on the state title too.
Justin Fields, I just feel he just showed a lot last night, and if he pulls that off against Alabama, even more.
He did show a lot.
It's hard to be a prisoner of the moment, but it's just like,
you don't have to hold me on. Like, I was going to hold on regardless. Like, I was going to stop for you.
Yo.
But when you say it to me, it's like, I feel disrespected. I'm like a child. He's like, yo, well, hold on. I was holding on anyway.
What happened this weekend with this guy? You all right?
I'm good. 2021.
You
ain't for the disrespect this year.
I'm not. I'm just talking about
you can't call something that's not disrespect. Disrespect.
That's disrespectful.
He said, hold on. We don't want to be talking over each other.
What does it matter? It's all about the context.
I didn't hear his tone.
Are you all right?
I learned that today.
What? Tone?
It's all about the context, I guess. Even if he doesn't feel like it was disrespectful. Like, all that matters is how I feel.
Was it to him?
If I never... Wait. So if I didn't mean to be disrespectful, and you took it disrespectful,
you gotta run with it. That's all that matters.
But ain't that
it doesn't matter how you feel.
That's how 99% of fights start.
But ain't that kind of a you problem?
You know what? I thought that until today.
You gotta ask
yourself. And then I figured out today that it's not a me problem.
It's not a you problem.
No, it's a we problem now. Because if I feel like it's disrespect, then you need to feel like it's disrespectful.
Do you apologize? Do you? I'm saying, like, in general, like, if I don't feel disrespected you, but you feel saying it back to myself, yes, you would probably should apologize.
But I feel if you would be disrespectful to me, now, not only do you gotta apologize to me, but you also have to be more conscious of what you're doing, what you're saying to me.
Hold on.
Because I'm gonna take it as disrespect.
Hold on.
Yeah, I'm hoping
that disrespectful.
No, I was trying to be. I didn't feel like that. Hold on.
See that
hold on was disrespectful.
But if I'm saying, but if your radar,
it doesn't matter. It just matters how I take it.
Your radar is already up, and I quote unquote disrespected you. If my apology comes right after that, you're not gonna accept it.
Probably not.
So what's the point?
I'm not sure. I mean, I probably would, but I'm figuring. I found out some things with that. I've learned some things.
Go ahead, Dixon.
But go ahead, Dix.
Sounds like a confusing relationship.
Woo!
No, that's what our friendship is. That's what our friendship is. Been 20 years in this month.
Yeah, it has been 20 years.
I feel like you had an epiphany, and like you're getting over the little brother syndrome. And it's like, I ain't gonna take it no more.
Well, me and Jason, the thing was, me and Jack weren't friends initially.
No, not as earth for him to punch me in the face.
Jack, actually, when I was probably 16, because they were all 18 and stuff, like, him and Tim were playing on the controllers at B-Waves house. They were playing.
He's gonna make it sound bad. So,
nah, because it is bad.
Listen,
it is.
Listen, the viewers, we've heard this story.
You heard this story?
We've heard this story so many times.
For real?
He's in
a space where he wants to share the hurt. I get it. So let him go.
Because you know we got different listeners.
We got listeners.
We got a listener that probably ain't heard this before. But I ain't gonna tell him now. Dixon said no. Dixon didn't know we heard this story.
I'm sorry. I didn't mean disrespect.
Nah, I took it as disrespect. It doesn't matter how you feel, how you say it. You can say to me all you want. If you don't feel like it was disrespectful. If I feel that way, that's all that matters.
We are 92 shows in, and this is what goes on.
We're getting back to their topic. What are we talking about?
I don't even know.
We're talking about Fields and Lawrence. Who you taking?
Oh, that's right. Go ahead, man. You told me to hold on.
Hold on.
I'm holding on now. I'm waiting for you.
Oh, my God. Listen, man. All I'm trying to say, I don't even know. I forget. Go ahead. Make your point.
I mean, there's no right or wrong. It's what you feel your team
needs. Did you just cave?
No, I didn't cave.
No, you caving.
I didn't cave.
You caved.
I forgot what I was going to say, but I said, make your point.
I got it. Soft in the new year.
Yeah, it's getting a little different. He's a little different now. So, my point is, Ray got to relax, first of all.
Yeah,
I seen that comment. Ray got to relax.
All right.
I'm going to relax. He always on your side. Doesn't matter. So, it's fine. All right. Lawrence. He didn't play bad. He had 4 turnovers, yes. Had interception, 3 fumbles. But he still had 400 yards passing.
Right.
Still had 3 touchdowns. Okay. He was slinging that thing. Pause.
So was Fields.
He definitely got to throw a pause at that.
Yeah, he got to throw a pause.
I know exactly what
I said he
about.
Was slinging that. And he was. You see some of his throws. Those are NFL throws. But when I watched Fields, and he threw 6 touchdowns and whatever, Fields was extremely motivated. And for him to come back after taking that hit, which I didn't think he was coming back, I thought every rib in his body was broken.
Should he have been ejected,
though? No, heck no. I called B-Way, it shouldn't happen.
That was in the torso.
No, he shouldn't have been ejected.
Helmet.
No, but he said because his head was down.
He squared up. I get it. But
I don't, it's a bad rule.
It should have just been a 15-yard.
Because it should be, the rule should be anything above the head and neck area.
But he was wearing
the crown of your helmet. That should be the rule.
He could have broke his neck on that if he wasn't wearing that.
So I just don't feel like he should have been ejected for that. I don't.
Oh, that's what I was going to say. Hold on.
And it does so. You know what? I understand. I know you're not doing it on purpose and to be the jerk.
No, I'm not. I'm really.
Yeah, I know you really.
You came to me.
Yes, I got it.
Fields played just good enough to get him to the number two pick. Because he dropped.
He was going to be number two pick.
Who's got the number two pick?
I don't know.
Bengals, no.
No, Jets.
Jets.
Jaguars, Jets.
Jaguars, Jets, Bengals. Eagles could have the third pick if everything breaks right.
Yeah. Oh, at least my question I wanted to ask you guys. Okay. Do you rather a Philadelphia win tomorrow to keep the Redskins out of it, or do you rather lose the Cowboys out of it?
It's not even about keeping the Cowboys out of it.
Because I want to play spoiler. Oh, they're I want to beat. I don't give a damn about the Cowboys.
They're not playing. They go anyway.
With the 7-9 record or whatever it is. They go with and Andy Dalton. More kudos to them. They didn't give up. They played whatever. Sometimes you just got to pat them on the back. I want to play spoiler. I want them to beat the Redskins, not allow the Redskins in. But I know some Eagles fans hate what the Cowboys would not allow it.
Yes.
Do you think you as a player could just not show, not play, and not be competitive?
That's how you get hurt. If I'm on the field, I'm competing.
They're sitting a lot.
So then if you was you, you want to win.
Of course.
But as a fan, it's ABCs. As an Eagles fan, everybody knows ABCs. Anybody but the Cowboys.
So you want us to lose tomorrow?
I just don't want the Cowboys.
Listen, are you the biggest Eagle fan tomorrow that you ever been?
I feel like Carson's gonna play. He's gonna play for his life tomorrow.
No, I'm asking you though. What do you
want
to see?
I want the Eagles to win tomorrow.
Obviously, you're an Eagle fan tomorrow.
Yeah.
All right.
Like, I want him to play good football. I want him to play football.
I thought it was Jalen.
But breaking news, Jim Schwartz, our defensive coordinator, is stepping away from football for a year.
He's about to get fired. How are you retiring?
that's why he got out.
He's trying to change the narrative.
No,
Jim Schwartz was a good, he's a decent coach. I think we don't have the players. It's not Jim Schwartz. I think his scheme sucks at times,
he's too conservative.
I think the players that we have from Howie is a problem.
Can the Eagles beat the Redskins with Alex Smith starting the quarterback?
I don't think he's starting.
If he starts.
And Heineke kids are starting.
Yeah, the Heineke. Alex Smith practiced yesterday, so they're thinking he may play.
Eagles are a bad football team.
They are.
And if they win, it's surprising against whoever quarterback you want to put out there. Moving forward.
Man, he moved forward quickly.
No, that's definitely. I don't even know why they came on. Thanks for asking that question.
He
built that question
up. I like to converse with my friends.
You built that question up. I thought you were going to ask something like
provocative. It wasn't a good question?
No, but I don't care about the Eagles no more.
I'm asking an Eagle fan. I don't care if you don't care.
But you asked me.
So you're one of the bad Eagle fans, though.
I'm not a bad Eagle fan. I'm a realist.
No, you're a terrible Eagle fan.
I want them to get the number three pick.
You're like the, you know, when we played in the vet, you know how bad those fans were? You're one of those Eagle fans.
I sat the 700 bucks.
Yeah, at the vet. Yeah, I can't mess with those Eagle fans.
We had a jam underneath them.
Why?
Listen.
It's genuine.
You guys are very emotional. You got to relax.
Emotional.
I didn't call it disrespectful.
No, you didn't, but you felt it. You felt it.
Yeah, moving forward.
Move forward. Texas football.
Texas who? A&M Longhorns.
The Longhorns. I said Texas A&M. I said Texas.
Okay. I was wondering. You said Texas football.
You could have been talking about Texas Tech.
They made a big move today in firing their coach, Tom Herman.
After they said that he'd be back next year.
And on the same day, they went out and hired Alabama's offensive coordinator. Steve Sarkisian.
You know what's more impressive about Alabama? Is they lose a coordinator every year.
They do.
They lose a coordinator every year, whether it's defensive or offensive, and then every year they're back in the college football playoffs.
Alabama is where you go when your career dies, and then Nick Saban like resuscitates you, and then you become to this head coach like you weren't ever a head coach before.
He needed that. Steve Sarkisian.
Yeah, Lane Kiffin did the same thing with him.
Yeah.
He did the same. Well, after Lane Kiffin was terrible in the NFL and college before, he did it with my man in Maryland right now, who's a Towson grad, Loxley, who was their offensive coordinator for a year.
I'm going to get Muschamp.
Yeah, Muschamp too?
Yeah.
He did have Muschamp too. Went to Florida.
Yeah.
Loxley was at New Mexico and was real terrible. He might have won like two games in 3 years. Goes to Alabama, everybody forgets. Now he got the Maryland job. And they're doing a great job. And now Steve Sarkisian is the latest one. After he was getting drunk in the football offices after games.
Gee, that's not judging.
It's hard.
We're all battling demons, bro.
It is, and I feel bad. But I feel more bad that black coaches don't get these opportunities.
We're always coming back to that.
Yeah, you know, I took it there.
Fine.
I know. I make 45 over here, pretty uncomfortable.
You can't play the race card every time.
If we got fired,
Colts is not getting his job right now. Just give me some other.
What do you mean?
That deserve the
can't even name black coach
the Texas job.
That's terrible.
What happened to Charles? What happened to Charlie Strong? What happened to him? Where's he at now?
Probably on the couch. Show him.
No, he's the head coach.
This guy's terrible.
It's the disrespectful we give him NCAA, man.
Number one is not an incredible amount.
Locke's a black coach doing a good job.
Can I go?
Lovey just got fired at Illinois.
I heard him get. He might be considered for the Eagles' D coordinator position.
Yeah.
You done? You finished or you done?
Hold on.
I'm holding
on.
Hold on.
My man out in Arizona State is doing well.
Sumlin
got fired.
No, not Sumlin, man.
Sumlin at Arizona.
Oh,
I heard about Tom Herman.
He played to win the game. That guy.
There's probably a handful of black head coaches in college, and that's
the problem. Is there's not many African American coaches. Period.
At Power Five. Yeah.
That's not true.
At the high level.
At the high level. What are you talking about?
Did you look at staff like yesterday? There were a lot of black coaches on the sideline.
No, I'm talking about head coaches.
Oh, those are players. Those are players dressed like staff. Nah, they was former players that came back to try to get their coaching degree.
It's disrespectful what they do to black coaches, man. At every level, like we can score and run touchdowns, but we can't call play. Call defense?
You can. Yeah. Look at Andy Reid. He always hired a black offensive and defensive coordinator.
If Steve Sarkisian's black, does he get the Texas job? After what he meant.
There's no black coach ever going to coach the Texas again after Charlie Strong.
Well, they're
they didn't want Charlie Strong.
Yeah, they didn't want. He could have won a national.
Do what all when they hired Charlie Strong?
The boosters run everything.
They hired him, guys. They hired the basketball coach and Charlie Strong around the same time.
He's still there.
Shaq is not. He can pass.
They got a top 20 program.
Your name's Shaka, though.
Yeah.
Yeah, they can't hide your blackness if your name's Shaka.
I don't care how white you look. Your name's Shaka. We claim you.
You don't look white.
He's not black.
Blackish.
He's blackish.
I don't disrespect Shaka like that, man.
If his name was John Smith, you'd be like, oh, they have nothing like that. But it's Shaka. They're like, oh, word.
You guys are disrespectful, man. Bottom line is, if a black coach gets caught drinking and having liquor in the office and doing all this other dumb stuff, we're never going to hear from him again.
I don't know how to agree with that.
He might be at Millsville.
That's not a bad place to coach.
Name one.
That's a full-time job.
Name one.
Name one what?
One coach. That's.
But I can't name one.
I don't know one that got caught drinking.
But name one that hasn't been caught.
We don't get second chances,
but you can't name one that got caught in that position. I can't think of one that.
Name me a black coach.
I know Mike Lurie got caught.
The only person I can name is Steve Sarkisian that got caught in that
position. He's back on TV.
Name me a black coach that got two good jobs.
Two good jobs?
Yes.
Period?
Yes.
I got two good jobs.
Doc Rivers.
Doctors love jobs.
I'm a college football.
Oh, you said any. No, okay. No.
And Doc went to the Clippers.
I'm going
to
say something. Someone got two good jobs. Texas A&M and Arizona. Those are two major jobs.
You're
saying a coach.
Arizona is not a good place to coach?
No, a black coach has gotten two good jobs.
It was both Power 5 schools. But they're not two good jobs. I don't care who you're coaching for. If it's in a Power 5, you get both those jobs. Those are good jobs.
No, I'm saying name a coach who has gotten two good jobs.
I just told him. Someone.
James Franklin.
Vanderbilt was not a good job. You can't say
you cannot say this guy's coaching at any level not a good job. How can you say that? Kevin Sumlin, Texas A&M.
Start.
Arizona. Hell of a not good job.
But he had a chance to move on. He got his dream. Like, he started.
No, he wanted people like, from, he wanted Nick Saban to get
started. He started Vanderbilt. He started SEC.
First of all,
he won there. He won there, right?
Listen, first of all, Franklin left Vanderbilt to go to Penn State.
Exactly.
He got the chance to move on. Once a black coach gets fired, you rarely hear from him again. And you said someone.
He got fired.
Yes.
And he got hired.
And he got hired at Arizona.
And he got fired.
And he got fired again.
You won't
you call Arizona a good job.
But college
but they never won.
They're a Pac-12 team.
You hired this black coach and you act like it's a great job all of a sudden?
You don't see a lot of
it's his job to turn it around. And is it not? That's not what he's hired for? To make a team better?
But that's saying they're bad. First of all,
Alabama wasn't really winning when Nick Saban went there.
Can't even name what
they weren't winning when he went to Florida. Alabama. They weren't really winning when he went to LSU. And he keeps on winning.
No, well,
he went to Michigan State.
I'm not saying that. I'm saying he wins where he goes.
Yes. That's if Saban
goes. He turns them into powerhouses.
If Saban goes to Arizona, they won't be a powerhouse.
That is so disrespectful.
Alabama, one of the richest histories in college football.
Yeah, but they went a long time.
LSU, one of the richest histories in college football.
If Alabama has a rich history because of Bear Bryant.
If Nick Saban goes to Arizona, he could give them the same Chargers and cars that he gives them in Alabama. No. We all know that.
I think so.
He could turn on the hat when
Nick
goes.
Nick wins.
Nick is not going. He's not.
Oh, he's not going
Arizona.
To.
I'm not saying. Yeah, but he wouldn't win at Arizona.
He won at Michigan State.
You could put Belichick at Arizona. You could put Jesus at Arizona. Whoa. Arizona's going to be Arizona.
That's blasphemous.
Name me a black coach.
If Jesus can't turn it around,
you
don't
see a lot of retread coaches in college.
So I think that's disrespectful. I think Jesus can turn it around.
Jesus could. But
this guy turned like a whole thing of water to like wine to drink. It's amazing.
He probably wants to run the option.
Is that not amazing? Like, you can't turn a Pac-12 around? Stop. You can't say something like that.
Hold on. You think Jesus would run the option? You run in the mirror? Just to make it more difficult for himself?
Nah, air raid.
Air raid? No.
Air raid.
He's running the old offense just because he's Jesus.
He going to park that thing.
No, he's going
to run. No, triple option.
No, he's going to run the wishbone.
Check with me.
Why would he run the wishbone? No one wants to run that off. That's a bad offense.
It's old, man.
If
it's old
you dominate school. With it, you see when Navy and Army get to running it on you, can't stop it.
It's the same three plays all game.
But imagine doing it with elite athletes, not at Navy or Army.
We're talking
about Jesus. You know what? You should have brought that up. Jesus is going to make things happen.
We're talking about Jesus coaching in college football right now.
It's going to be like angels in the outfield.
Listen,
but that's a black man.
Who?
Jesus.
I think that.
Right.
I don't argue that.
But there's not a lot of retread coaches in college football as is. Once you mess up in college football,
Lane Kiffin had 16 jobs.
Because he's Monty Kiffin's son. Name me another one that really went through it and sucked everywhere and got balls.
Did
you guys
say balls again?
He ooted, so I felt the need to pause it.
Brett Bielema.
Who?
Bielema.
Bielema.
Wisconsin? Where else he going?
Bielema.
Arkansas.
Bielema? Yeah.
He didn't get fired at Wisconsin. He won at Wisconsin, and I think Arkansas
was a dream
job.
Yeah.
Arkansas,
yeah.
He didn't fire. He didn't get fired.
Yeah, no,
didn't.
Name somebody else that
I'm shooting everything down, baby. 2021, I'm shooting everything down. All
right, throw somebody else at you?
Yeah.
How about the terrible coach of Texas Tech that got hired by the Arizona Cardinals?
Yeah, and he's winning in
Arizona.
They win this week. They're in the playoffs. So there goes your argument.
He's not winning. He's been there 2 years. He's got a losing season.
And he got Kyler Murray.
And he's been all right. He had Kyler Murray the whole time.
If they win this week, I think they're in. I think whoever wins that game is in the playoffs.
Dang.
That's embarrassing.
My man is just raining out there. I've never heard so much water coming down.
Do you hear that? Jesus trying to drive.
That sounds dangerous.
Listen, man. Bottom line is, if you're black, you're not getting
give one good
a second job. What are you talking about?
You said you give me.
Well, moving forward, man, because this is getting out of hand.
Hold on.
No, I'm done holding on.
Steve Sarkisian. What are you talking about?
He rehabilitated himself.
Yeah, okay.
Where did he get fired from? Atlanta Falcons?
Washington. Wow. Well, yeah, Washington, where he had the.
And then he went to Atlanta Falcons and was a.
A coordinator there,
and he left or got fired and went to Alabama. But I mean, he got hired at Alabama to be like a consultant first.
Right. Yeah, wait your turn, and then
when Kiffin left,
coordinator leaves, you're gonna be next.
Is this not one of the best offenses in the history of college football?
I mean, he deserves it.
That's what I'm saying. Like, when the results,
when the results
add up, you got to give the guy
a chance. Do you think he deserves a job? Not if you take away from the drinking thing didn't happen. Does he deserve the job?
No.
Just off numbers.
What is he cutting? Who deserves the job?
Some guys can just be coordinators. Some guys can just be.
All right, so who deserves the job?
There's probably a lot of guys out there.
Okay, well, that, so you're not giving me no names.
Deion deserves a job.
Do we like what Deion's doing, Deion Sanders is doing in Jackson State?
What's he doing?
That's cool.
He just got like three more.
He got three more four-star recruits.
He got Auburn's D-tackle to transfer there yesterday. Like, he's doing things. Doing big, big things.
Yeah, some of them happen to be his son, so like, what does he really know?
Why would you not like
him? Because he's got about, I think he's got 12 four-star recruits now.
It's the best.
Jackson State would never get them. Let's forget that. They would never get them if he wasn't there.
Hold on. I got a better question. What happened to that kid that committed to Howard?
He's playing right now.
He's playing.
I thought he was out.
No, he's playing.
Is he doing anything?
No.
It's two of them. It's two kids for Howard.
It's hard to keep up with basketball, man, because every other game like is getting COVID canceled, and it's just a mess right
now. So is that like a one-year thing? You think we're moving towards black kids going to HBCUs?
We should all go to HBCUs.
Yeah, it's going to be outside the mountain, out of mind soon. So after this, like, you know, they had a lot of energy coming. It's going to be.
Here comes 45.
I'm just saying, it's a hard
thing. It happens, though. These kids weren't even committing to these black houses until the BLM movement.
You turn on the TV and your band is bigger than you. Why would you want to go to that school and play football? But the band is more important than you. Why would you want to go there?
You got a good point there.
No, the same reason.
That's the selling point, man.
The same reason that, like, Puerto Ricans walk around with a Puerto Rican hat on. The same reason China folks live in Chinatown. Like, we gotta support our own, man.
So why don't they go?
You lost me, man.
So why don't they go?
You lost me.
Why don't
they go? Yeah, why don't more... You see all them black kids playing for Dabo? I'm asking a good, legit question. I'm watching the game, I was like, this guy got every top black recruit in the country. Why don't they go play for HBCU?
They can start at the
HBCU. And he supports some things that would that otherwise... don't benefit them at all.
But at that age,
black coaches. Exactly. At that age, black kids don't care necessarily. They want to win.
They want to win, yes. And they want to, no, they want to be famous.
Did you watch that movie?
They want more followers.
Did it come out yet on Disney Plus?
Some people like the lights.
Yeah, it's out.
Some people watch the lights.
Yeah. I mean, it's hard for HBCU to compete, like, facility-wise. Nobody wants to go there. If you go visit Morgan State, and then you go visit LSU.
Oregon.
Like, it's hard.
Oregon has the top of the line facilities, and I mean, it's incredible. Nike doesn't.
Until we are about us, and like parents are on board with like supporting and sending these kids there, and they can win, and we get money in that conference. Because if more recruits go there, more TV supporters go there, and then we
got a comment.
How about we don't? How about we don't?
How about you read it, Dixon? Read the comment.
It's two comments.
All right, we got two comments from Vanessa Miles. That's not true, Jack. Hashtag HBCU grass. Then she also goes on to say, attending an HBCU as a black individual will more than likely be the best experience.
See, I didn't say that. All I said was, as a player, the band is more important than the team.
It's not true.
It sure feels like it. They get advertised, like,
man, the bands be getting jiggy.
I'm just saying, as the athlete in you, like, you're going to Clemson, you're nobody cares about the band there. Nobody cares. You're going to Penn State, Alabama, nobody cares about, like, they're not.
That's a big deal. Penn State, the blue band.
They're not the big deal. They're not showing that at halftime. They're really not.
We went to Towson? I said, yo, that band is rocking.
But they mentioned Johnny U.
Oh, we were about to get him, like, yo, that band is rocking right there. That's not even HBCU.
I didn't mean it no slight. That's an experience. That has to be a great experience to go to HBCU. I didn't mean it that way. I just meant as a player. If you go and everybody goes, the game normally starts till halftime. That's what it feels like.
The game normally starts till halftime.
That's not a slight. That's not a thing. That's just how it feels. And that's not. And if you're a band member there, that's got to be a great feeling. That's probably why you go to an HBCU.
I mean, he's got a little bit of a point. Like, how many times did Drumline show the football team?
At all. They had a football team.
They've never showed them. It's like, these guys are playing at halftime, but we've never seen the football team actually playing football.
It was a movie about the band.
It's a true story. It's a true story.
Why would they show
the Because they play when they're in the stands. They never showed a pass in the damn football game. Like, one.
At all.
I'm just saying. Like,
wasn't it called Drumline?
Yeah.
So why are we talking about the football?
But this at the football game.
We only play at the football games. You ain't playing at basketball games.
That's not true for HBCUs. They have HBCU dance events. It's a big deal. They have their own little tournaments and things like that.
They had the BT Classic.
Can you imagine seeing great football and a great dance?
They only went to college.
I don't know because I didn't see it the whole time in Drumline.
For the record, Dabo has like 3 black coaches out of 17 on the staff.
What's that, a problem?
Yes.
That's like every other job you go to.
But ain't so disrespectful.
About 8%.
Man, get 45 talking, man. Let's keep 45 talking, and you guys will understand why we call them.
What is bad about what I said? I don't understand you guys are thinking it. I say I'm the bad guy.
Maybe they weren't qualified.
I work at a place with a lot of minority staff members.
Yeah, you work in York.
I don't know what I meant. Wow. I have no idea what I meant by that.
I just want to say that was different.
I wanted to take it back as soon as you said. I saw the look in his eyes.
I'm joking. Shout out to Clovis.
Shout out to YC in general, man.
Yeah. Shout them out. I just drove through there.
No, you did.
Yeah, I did.
You got off the highway and got on 30.
I drove through there. No, you said I drove through there.
That's not New York City.
Ain't got to be right. I'm in the city. I'm in the county.
All right.
Moving forward.
Should I have drove downtown?
Yeah, you should have went to the city, man. Great people there. Great folks.
The White Rose.
Listen.
Where are we going next?
Well, you got to ask a question. Can I ask a question?
Absolutely, okay. Jack.
So,
I want you to ask a question.
Let's go in there.
I hope you ask a question.
As parents, as parents of young kids, right? I don't know if you guys have watched that movie Soul. Just came out on Pixar, Disney.
I have not.
Okay, so it's a big deal.
It's a great movie.
You did watch it?
I did.
Okay, so at least I get to talk to one person that watched it. I don't know if Dixon watched it.
I'll sit back on this one.
Well, okay, anyway. Pixar and Disney in general. Do you have a problem when the star of the movie is a black lead, and for more than half of the movie, the black person is not a black person?
He's a ghost.
No, it's Tina Fey.
No, but I'm saying.
No, but it's Tina Fey, the white woman, gets be the black person.
You're right.
And Princess and the Frog, the girl.
That wasn't more than half the movie, though.
But it felt like it.
Right.
And it felt like the character became more likable when it became a white woman. Do you have an issue with that?
So they transformed
the
black person?
No, okay.
Black person?
So
that's not what I got out of that.
That's what I got. A deep dive. I watched the movie like 2 or 3 times.
Already. I liked it.
No. I really liked it.
I like Jamie Foxx.
When he went to the barbershop. And he automatically assumed that the barber only wanted to talk about jazz. Mm-hmm. And that's what he cared about. But no, he asked him about himself. And he had a whole different conversation with him. That was her talking.
You mean the person became more likable?
Yes.
The black person in the movie became more
likable. As the
white voice.
Right. Do you have an issue with that?
So the black person trains.
Okay. Let me break down synopsis of the movie. He, music teacher, he finally gets his big break.
It's Jamie Foxx playing
this. Jamie Foxx finally gets a big break in his life. He's going to play with this jazz singer that he looks up to. He's excited. He's running on his way home, and he falls down a sewage trap, and he dies. Right? In the movie. You know, they don't like go into detail. He just falls down. He goes up to heaven. He's going up to the bright light. And he feels, no, there's no way I can die right now. There's no way. So he goes backwards. And he ends up, in between. So he meets a character, and they end up coming back to Earth. One of them goes into his body, her, and he goes into the cat's body. It's a cartoon. It's whatever. So he's trying to get back into his body to switch with her, and that's when his character becomes more likable in the movie as a white woman.
Oh,
it's him, but the person in there is a white Tina Fey.
Gotcha.
Princess and the Frog. She can't be the princess all the time. She had to turn into a frog.
Is that accurate?
I mean, yeah, that's a fair. But those are the only two movies I can think of that where they have a black lead.
That's a fair one. I thought the movie was strange at times.
Well, but it's Pixar. Everything has feelings.
Yeah,
and this one was like the black people.
I didn't like the fact that
they do cars.
There weren't really people for more than half the movie. They were like ghosts, or more than souls for half the movie.
You didn't get the racial vibe from it? You would.
Oh, is he?
Wow.
Is he tone deaf? Is that what you're saying?
You know what? I didn't get that from the movie. All
right.
Surprise.
Am I looking for something that's not there? Is that what it is?
I think what you're saying is a fair analysis of the movie.
But if we had
you're looking that deep into it.
It's not that I'm looking that deep, but these are only two movies that I can think of with that sample size. You give me two movies where your characters are, your main characters are black. Why can't they just be black the whole movie? Fucking every other movie, there's the white character gets to be white. He doesn't become black, or he doesn't become like every, the two movies where your selling point. You have a black director. You have, you know, HBCU grad. I can't think of his name right now, but in Soul, Jamie Foxx. Your whole selling point is black, black, black. Why can't he be a black guy in a whole movie?
Hey, as we get ready to wrap up, I didn't think about the Chris Rock movie that he was in, where
he did come back as a white man. Didn't
came back like an old white guy. Remember, he started off as a black guy.
That's funny.
Came back as like an old white guy.
Is it a cartoon?
No, nah, it's a movie. No, it's a movie.
Chris Rock.
He was a comedian.
Yeah.
Man, I can't remember the movie. Man.
So it's like a Trading Places kind of movie.
Yeah.
Okay. I mean, yeah. See, but it's always that that narrative happens a lot.
I don't know how I feel about that.
What?
I don't know about that.
Which one?
Now you said it. I don't know about Soul.
I don't hate it. I love the movie.
Changed my mind on it a little bit.
I love the movie. I'm just saying, it's always like, you know.
Down to Earth was a Chris Rock movie.
Okay.
Down to Earth. Yeah. Good movie. You remember watching one time.
Nah, whatever.
You don't like it?
Yeah, I've never seen it.
Like, that's disrespectful.
I apologize to Chris Rock when I see him.
No, to me, that's to say, I don't worry about it. Like, eh.
I don't think he said, eh.
I don't see that disrespect. That's all that matters.
No, that would have been disrespectful. He said, eh.
How can you wear something that says, like, WWJD, like, what would Jesus do, and you are disrespectful?
If you were giving Jesus the attitude you're giving me right now, he'd slap you across your face.
I don't think Jesus
would. And I ain't doing it. That's the one time I'm not going to listen to the bracelet.
That's a terrible.
You think man. Jesus would have recruited me? What? No. He would have some red flags.
Well, he ran a 4.8. He's not faster than me in my offense.
I wasn't a 4.8.
What were you? Let's tell the world. What was
4.89?
I'm faster 40 times than 4.5.
Before I
got there.
No, no, no. Stop.
I'm telling you my
first. What was your 40 time electronically at Penn State?
My fastest 40 time was a 4.5.
What was your last 40 time?
It don't matter. I was hurt.
No, what was your last 40 time?
How are you going to judge a man when he's hurt?
You were not hurt.
I was hurt.
Hey, he tore you.
I'm hurt you
pretty bad.
I was not hurt.
I was there.
Any football players watching? That's like a wrap up music right there.
Yeah, I don't know what the heck's going on.
No, no, Jack, man, Jack, you got any shout out to
you out here? Pause.
What? You're a wild boy.
You're a wild boy.
Yeah, I know, man. You
shout out talking to the mic.
I know you guys don't listen to the podcast, like, after we upload and everything, and we do all
I'll
the
listen this week, B.
And, like, you know, all the extra stuff that I do, that you guys just show up and talk for an hour, and then I can do a
later. You know, be respectful. So anyway, I always got to make a sacrifice.
But anyway, when you talk to the microphone, it sounds better, and there's no echo, so I wanted to get close to the microphone.
Point it to your face, B.
Shut up, man. Just shut up.
I'm being
real. You got me saying, show up in front of people like that. Man, I apologize, Facebook. You don't talk like that. He gets me that way sometimes.
I get you that way.
Good.
I said, shout out to everybody.
Shout out to everybody. That's what Jack does. Who's everybody?
He's specific. Like, we said, like, is this what I say, man? Like, sometimes say it is what it is. It really isn't.
You didn't really have to go into detail.
I wanted to deep dive on Soul. I'll do whatever I please. You ask me a question, I'm going to answer it.
That's right, Jack.
Ryan Garcia. You know, I told you I want to cover that. It's my, no, we
man,
have a question,
to wrap
we have a question about
wrap.
Ryan Garcia.
Oh, we do.
Thank you. Yeah, you know, the customer's always right, or your listener's always right.
No,
what did that say?
I ain't seen a comment.
You see the Ryan Garcia match? Who's that? Mr. Tony Cruz asked. So, yes, I happened to see the Ryan Garcia match as I walked in. That was a nice left hook to the body. You know, he went down early in the fight, and he got up, you know, first time getting hurt in the fight. So it was nice to see him come back from adversity.
Gotta go, man.
Do we?
Yeah.
Okay. Well, I had to.
No, we don't.
He has a question. I had to answer.
The Cleveland show, black actor was played by a white man. I didn't know that. You know that?
No, I
don't watch the Cleveland show.
I'm getting mad at
me either. But I don't like it.
That does suck.
Apparently no one knows that.
Did you know that one woman did all the voices for the Simpson character? Did you know that?
No.
She happened to be white. Yes, sir.
Yeah, that's not true.
She did all the voices.
Bart. Or Grant. I thought Bart was like a little white lady in a chair. Like a wheelchair.
She did a lot of voices.
Why would her being in a wheelchair matter?
No, I'm just trying to help describe her.
What is his head?
Why would her being in a wheelchair help describe her?
Because she was in a wheelchair. Because
she was handicapped.
That helps describe someone.
I just want to tell the listeners.
You know that one that was rolling down the block there, the handicapped wheel.
I apologize.
All right. But anyway, shout out to Ryan Garcia. I want to see him play to Gervonta Davis or Tiafoe.
Absolutely. I do want to see one.
Hell of a play. Yeah. He can win.
Red.
What?
Do you have any shout outs?
We want to fight and everything after his shout out. You gotta come back.
I saw a question and I answered it.
Did you not see our producer in the background like, yo, wrap it up?
Man, no. I don't want to look over that way.
I can't see anything.
He doesn't even like me.
He should, the way you treat him.
That's my guy. It's like fourth grade.
Y'all got beef?
Never.
Oh, okay. Cause you be making up beef.
Nah, I never.
And you be having fake beef. What are you talking about?
But who?
Me and you be having fake beef.
You are not a likable person.
Yo.
That's not fake beef. That is just the fact.
2020 shout outs.
2021?
Me?
Well, we're gonna find out.
We're talking about like 2008 me.
2008 was bad.
It was.
I was trying.
Mind you, people that are watching right now.
All
right, hold on. People that are watching right now.
The hold on.
No. Go ahead. No.
You asked me my shout outs. I'm going to give you my shout
outs. He said, mind you.
Nah, I'll give you my shout outs. You asked me. You can use your time for another time. Use your time for your shout outs. Can I go?
Go ahead, man.
Shout out to Olivia Sedwick, I think. Don't worry about who it is.
Who you asking?
I was asking myself. Who was asking me?
We didn't know who you're talking about.
Olivia Sedwick. We didn't know who she was, man.
Also, Tori Mack, I think. I hate, like, if I get the names wrong, I apologize. But I had two very good conversations with them today. They did most of the talking. And they helped me out a lot. So I appreciate it.
Huh? So it takes to get a shout out? A good conversation?
It was different, though. It was more on a spiritual level. You wouldn't understand.
I would.
So.
Hey.
Nice.
That was a jab?
No.
Nah, might have been true.
Shout out to Olivia Sedwick and Tori Mack. They helped me a lot today. I appreciate everything y'all talked to me and told me, and hopefully one day I can repay y'all for that.
Shout out to Elisa Mack and who?
Lisa.
Whatever you said.
So you gotta get it right. If you want to repeat what I say.
I think
that's
the rest of
them. Tori Mack.
Shout out to Tori Mack
and Olivia Sedwick.
And Olivia Sedwick, because if you had a very good conversation with them, I'm hoping that you made them a better person. Okay?
Highly doubt.
Just saying.
And he's very dense. I don't know. It has to be something heavy for it to get through with him, though.
Jesus, man.
Wow, you guys are. You know what?
You said I'm not a likable person. What do you think I'm going to say about you?
Oh, mind you.
I said it respectfully.
Can we get out of here?
There's no respectful way to say that.
Can we get out of here?
Can we go?
Mind you, these two are best friends. Like, Red was in Jack's. He was the best man at Jack's wedding.
I don't think men have besties, man.
Would you have gotten that from their interaction?
You know why I was just the best man at his wedding?
Okay.
Brandon Way said he couldn't do it.
No, whoa.
That's the kind of friend
I never asked.
He is.
Hold on.
I was in
he was in the way.
I heard I was third choice.
No, you're my first choice.
I heard Tim, I heard B-Way, then me.
Wow, but they were in the wedding, so how does that make any sense?
That's what I mean.
They're lying to the people.
All he did was just flip us. And he was like, Brittany gonna sit here now, because y'all didn't want to do it.
Wow.
I just want to say, it feels like he's taking your friendship for granted. Like,
he is.
You didn't understand it. You didn't know the seriousness of it.
I told him when I picked him as my best man why I was doing it. Yeah. No, he was my first choice. At that point in life,
ask him.
If I get married today, he probably would be in the way.
Ask him how serious I took. When it was time for the best man to play his role.
Oh.
When the best man was time to play his role, I did it the best of my ability.
That was a great night at Allentown.
My man. All right, then.
What happened at Allentown, fellas?
What do you mean? You were there? Come on, babe.
Let's leave things alone. This is for
OP
Facts After Dark.
Shout out to the Subwoofer family as always. If you didn't already, make sure you go out and get your Roku box. TCP TV is live. All your favorite shows are live on there.
Or you can just buy a Roku TV. I'm just saying.
Or buy a Roku TV. I got a Roku TV with mine, so it's easier to watch. I was up late last night watching King's Court. My fault, Dixon. I was about to say the Kings of Comedy.
It's 2021. You kind of should have a Roku TV, but hey, I don't know.
Yeah. Anyway, King's Court was live one day last night. I got a bunch of my man Dixon and Bill do their thing. So shout out to everybody that already got the TCP TV. Make sure you keep subscribing and show some love. All right? We're getting up out of here. We good? Everybody good?
Are we?
Shout out to Dixon on the board. Shout out to Red. Shout out to Jack. 2021 is officially in the building. Hey, we got 100 shows coming. We're at number 92 right now, so we're about to be 100 shows in 2021.
How about summertime? You know how our schedule will be.
We gonna make it to 100?
I don't know. Every
comments?
Every week's a different week. Something out of family. What up? We out of here, man. Damn, what you guys never done.